I heard that you're settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came true. Guess she gave you things I couldn't give to you. Old friend, why are you so shy? Ain't like you to hold back or hide from the light. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay awake, I couldn't fight it, and I'd hope to see my face, that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg. I remember you said sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, sometimes it hurts instead. Nothing compares, no worries or cares. Regrets and mistakes are memories made. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste? Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg. I remember you said sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg. I remember you said sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead. Sometimes it lasts in love, but sometimes it hurts instead.
Wow. Getting a little choked up. Welcome to 5 at 5, episode 4. I'm so happy you guys are here. Hi, Cuzzy. Hi, Mandy. My dad is here, and Laura, and my brother, Connor. Gabe's here. My grandmother's here. Hi, Puffin. Wow, we've got an 82-year-old and an 82-day-old here. Hi, Cora. That's the shout-out for you. That song just really made me choke up, because happy Father's Day to all the wonderful dads out there. Like I said on last week's episode, I have always felt that the greatest chapter in my life will be to be an amazing father, and I really look forward to that day because I love kids so much. I'm feeling this desire to share something that I've never shared before with a lot of people. Father's Day has always kind of had a weird twang to me because I don't know my biological father, my sperm donor, as I prefer to refer to him, because that's what he was. And it brought me a lot of grief and pain in my life because it was very confusing as a kid to understand abandonment and that whole concept. But I was extremely lucky, and my real father, David Darab, came into my life when I was 9 months old and adopted me. And this day is such a celebration of him because he's such an amazing person. And I'm just so grateful to him. He's so kind and so gentle. And for the longest time, I pushed him away because I was confused about my own birth story. And I'm so happy that we're close now because I love him so much and I'm so happy for his life that he has now. Happy Father's Day. So next, wow, that just felt like a skin got released off of me. And I love my brothers too, and I'm so grateful for you, and I couldn't imagine not having you in my life. Next up is Follow the Sun by one of my favorite artists. His name is Xavier Rudd. He's super hippie and awesome. And this song, just listen to the lyrics, because it just has such a joy about life. It just reminds you to breathe and be present in the moment. So this is Follow the Sun by Xavier Rudd. Love this song. It just reminds me that, like, we have so much to be grateful for. You have your ears to hear beautiful music. You have your eyes to see all the beauty that life has to offer. You have your stomach to process food. You have your feet to walk and go around the world. You have your toes to help you walk. You've got your back to hold you up. We've got so much to be grateful for at all times, and that song just reminds me of that. That was Follow the Sun by Xavier Rudd. Now, next up we have Pray by Justin Bieber, and it was one of his first songs, but it's just as pertinent now.
I just can't sleep tonight.
It's in the papers, it's on the TV, it's everywhere that I go. Children are crying, soldiers are dying, some people don't have a home. But I know there's sunshine beyond that pain, I know there's good times beyond that rain. Hey, can you tell me how I can make a change? I close my eyes and I can see a better day. I close my eyes and pray. I close my eyes and I can see a better day. I close my eyes and I pray for the broken hearted. I pray for the life's not started. I pray for all the lungs not breathing. I pray for all the souls that need a break. Can you give them one today? Oh, Pray by Justin Bieber. Now, I do consider myself a believer, for anybody that knows what that is. I love Justin Bieber. He can kind of do no wrong to me. But that song is really beautiful because it just kind of helps you sit and realize, like, there's a lot more stuff going on in life than just my own personal bullshit. And having empathy and compassion for that, or at least attempting to have empathy for that, is a really positive, beautiful thing, and I encourage that. So next up, I want to do a little reading. You know, lots of like amazing quotes are going around the internet right now, and I found these two this week, and I want to share them with you. I've gotten into some conflict with people as of late, with COVID and the riots and things happening around the world. I think the energy levels are high. We just passed the summer solstice last night, so if you're feeling an abundance of crazy, confusing energy, that's why. And it's important to reflect on those times. So I'm gonna share this with you. It's by Conscious Soul Tribe, which is on Instagram if you wanna check it out. I'm slowly learning that even if I react, it won't change anything. It won't make people suddenly love and respect me. It won't magically change their minds. Sometimes it's better just to let things be, let people go. Don't fight for closure, don't ask for explanations, don't chase answers, and don't expect people to understand where you're coming from. That happens to me a lot. I'm slowly learning that life is better lived when you don't center it on what's happening around you, and instead what's happening inside you. Work on yourself and your inner peace. You know, I've run into situations recently, like I said, where I've been having conflict with people that I really care about, and it makes you feel bad when you feel like you have to stand up for something you believe in, especially if you feel like you're standing up for something that is affecting other people. But I've learned through this process that I can't change people. Their reactions have very little to do with me, and it's mostly a projection of what they're feeling inside. I can't pull them out of the trenches with me, as much as I'd love to change or help people in that way. But the most I can do is continue working on myself and finding my own inner peace. The next reading I want to do, I found on Instagram. It's by a guy named Doug Williford, and it kind of has to do with current events right now. If my wife comes to me in obvious pain and asks, "Do you love me?" an answer of "I love everyone" would be truthful, but also hurtful and cruel in that moment. If a coworker comes to me upset and says, "My father just died," a response of "Well, everyone's parents die" would be truthful, but hurtful and cruel in that moment. So when a friend speaks up in a time of obvious pain and hurt and says, "Black lives matter," a response of "All lives matter" is truthful, but it's hurtful and cruel in that moment. All right, next up we have a song by a very frequent artist on this show. This is "Your Love is Extravagant" by Casting Crowns.
Extravagant. your friendship, it is intimate. I feel like moving to the rhythm of your open grace. Your fragrance is intoxicating in our secret place. Your love is extravagant. Spread them wide in the arms of Christ.
That is such a beautiful song. I know, Bree, isn't that the best song ever? One of my best friends, Sam, and I used to listen to Cast of Crowns a lot together. All right, for the final song, again, guys, I'm so glad you're here. This is so awesome. I love that we're doing this every week. Episode 4, 5 at 5. Hi to all of my loved ones that are watching. I'm very grateful. Last, I want to sing Imagine by John Lennon, a cappella, as we do on the last song here at 5 at 5. And I mean, these words speak for themselves. I'm gonna keep pauses in between the lines so you can really resonate and meditate on what's being said and what John Lennon predicted back in the day. What a powerful, amazing genius he was, taken from us way too soon. This is Imagine by John Lennon. Let's go ahead and take a deep breath. Let it out. Feel free to close your eyes. I probably will. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us, only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, and no religion to. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us and the world will be as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of men. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us and the world will be as one. Thank you so much for being here. Help drop boundaries, drop the barriers between people, and just love one another and be the absolute best you can possibly be. I love you. Thanks for being here. This was 5 of 5. We'll see you next week.